Hi, I'm Ann from the Chocolate Bells, and today I want to show you how to dip pretzel logs. Okay, I did a video on how to do the twisted pretzels. Very easy to do, but people are like, well, how do you do the logs? Well, we use a squeeze bottle, and I don't have the cap on the squeeze bottle right now because we don't need it. You're just going to use the squeeze bottle, and you have your pretzel log. All you do is you tilt the bottle, you dip it into the chocolate. You can wipe the excess off, shake the excess off. You don't want big puddles. Okay, you put that down on there and you continue to dip. Now this is the easiest way of doing this because you can turn the bottle to the side so that you can use the volume of your chocolate the best. It's not like you're in a bowl and you're trying to twist it in a bowl. This way you just tilt the bottle and twist your pretzel around a little, get the chocolate on there. You don't want too much. You want to be just able to, you know, coat the pretzel. Don't put too much on there. Put it on a piece of wax paper on a cookie sheet, or I have a quarter sheet board here. And you just continue dipping. Okay. And Patrick, would you find me my sprinkles over there, please? And just dip away. Now, don't let them set up on the table. You want these to harden in the freezer. They will look the nicest. Anytime you're doing the chocolate, it should harden in the freezer or the refrigerator if you don't have space in the freezer, because then it's going to look the nicest. If you don't harden them in the freezer or the refrigerator, what happens is they turn white and streaky because they're not setting up properly. And we take and we just dip them like that. Now, if you want to, you could take and put a little bit of sprinkles on, just sprinkle away. You know, you could put a whole bunch on if you wanted to. A little bit usually goes a long way. Gives it a little glitz and no work. Or you could use the mold painter squeeze bottle to drizzle. And usually I harden them first if I'm going to drizzle, but here's the mold painter squeeze bottle with the green chocolate in it and long strokes. So you squeeze out a little bit and then you just go back and forth like this. Look at how nice the drizzle is. And you just take those and you stick them in the freezer. Only about 5 minutes they'll take in the freezer and they'll be done in no time flat. Now if you had the, well, if we had these here that weren't already drizzled, we could take these pretzels and I would put a piece of wax paper down. Patrick, could I have a little piece of wax paper, please? And then we'll just go over with the mold painter squeeze bottle and drizzle that. And they'll set up, that part can set up right on the table. Okay, that's fine, just a little piece. Okay, technology here, it ripped a little bit while he tore it off. So now we have the wax paper down, and then you can go back again and you just drizzle back and forth, just like that. Look at how nice that is. Just continue. Put as much as you want on, or as little, and those will set up in a matter of a couple of minutes on the table, and they're really pretty, very easy to do. Remember to use the squeeze bottle. When you're done with this bottle at the end of the day, you shake the excess back into the bowl, put the bottle in the freezer on the side without the cap, harden it, and then crunch all your pieces back into your bowl, and you can melt those again. So I hope you have a good time making your pretzels. Enjoy, simple project. Have the kids help you. Take care. Bye-bye.